Hello everyone, Bhavik Choksi here. Today's video is just to clarify on one very problematic area in the May 2019 exams. This is a clarification on barter transactions. I've been flooded with doubts of students who are unfortunately baffled by the treatment which is done by the institute at multiple places on barter transactions. I'm just trying to clarify in a very quick way the accounting that you should be doing under Ind AS 16 fixed assets, 38 intangible, and Ind AS 40 in terms of barter transactions. What we have done is we have quickly outlined the rule, and then I've given you the illustrations and the exact thing which according to me should happen in each of them, each of the four illustrations in four places that are there in your study material. We just quickly understand the rule which is there under Ind AS 16, 38 or 40. Now the rule over here does not necessarily put one of them to be preferable. It says that in all the three places, it says that the fair value should be the fair value of the asset given up unless the fair value of the asset received is more reliable. Looking at an exam question as a student, unless a question tells you otherwise, it is very difficult to figure out what is more reliable, because you'll be looking at two separate fair values. And hence, we follow the institute solutions on what the institute thinks is the probable order. Now, if nothing is available, then as per the institute solutions, as we can quite clearly see in Ind AS 38, it is a fair value of the asset given up. And if that is not available, then fair value of the asset received. There is a lot of confusion in the students on sums which are there in Ind AS 16, the Pluto Limited question, and an example which is there in Ind AS 40. We are just going to quickly discuss the principles. We are not solving the sums, we are discussing the principles. I would want you to refer these illustrations. These are the four illustrations in your study material where barter quite clearly appears. First is Ind AS 16, illustration 2. This is a Pluto Limited question where we are acquiring a private jet and probably giving up land. In which case, what should the principle be? The principle should be the fair value of the asset given up unless the fair value of the asset received is more reliable. In this question, what is happening is the fair value of the asset given up and the fair value of the asset received is exactly the same. There is no difference at all. However, if one reads the explanation, it quite clearly appears that you need to take the fair value of the asset received. The entity is recording the jet at its fair value and not the fair value of the asset given up. According to me, it requires, this explanation needs to be changed. It is wrong. You have to value the transaction at the fair value of the assets given up. That is the land and the cash, not the fair value of the jet. Probably the institute has not come out with a change over here because the final numbers remain the same. There is no difference in the numbers, and hence the institute has not given up any changes over here. But because the fair value of the asset given up and received is the same, it does not really matter in this question. You look at illustration 38, and in illustration 38, in Ind AS 38, illustration number 7, this is on page 9.198. The question is very clear. The solution is also very clear. There is software and there is telecom license. In both cases of barter, the institute solutions are very clear. They have taken the fair value of the assets given up in sub-point 1. In sub-point 2, when the fair value of asset given up is not available, they have reverted to the fair value of the asset received. Now comes a problematic example on illustration on Ind AS 40. This is on page 9.246. Now, what has happened is the institute has come up with a change. There have been unfortunately, yes, and been some time away. It has come up with a corrigendum where it has given you the changes in the solutions of a certain questions. And this is the example where ICAI has actually changed. So where do we find the corrigendum? So on the institute's website under financial reporting, you will find the corrigendum to study material. So over here, if we go to this part, cannot highlight it here. So if you go on unit number 9 on page 248, you can see in the journal entry given in the example, read 8 lakhs as 7 lakhs and ignore the credit gain of 1 lakh. So the institute over here also has come back and has clarified explicitly that it wants to take the fair value of the assets given up. You can't be more clear than this. And as a result, irrespective of what is written in Ind AS 16 in explanation, you will follow, I'll again repeat, you will follow the fair value of the assets given up as the first preference and then go to the fair fair value of the assets received. The institute in its corrigendum has specifically amended one of its examples where there was an inconsistency, and it has come up to the fair value of the assets given up only. So we look at the fair value of assets given up and fair value of the assets received. And the last part is Ind AS 103, a new illustration that was added, illustration number 1. I think that is on page 16.5. In which case we have taken the fair value of the assets received, but if you read the question, it quite clearly says that what you are giving up is, or I think if I'm not wrong, it is fair value of the assets given up only taken, fair value of the assets given up. I think the land is given up and in return equipment and patent is acquired. So they've taken fair value of the asset given up only, not the fair value of the asset received. But over here, the explanation is because it is more reliable, which is correct. I think in that question, patent and equipment is acquired and in return land and cash is given. The question has told you explicitly that patent pertains to some a product which is fairly new and market is not yet developed, and hence the fair value that would be derived for such an asset is a less reliable fair value. So we have to take the fair value of the asset given up only, as it is more reliable. I hope this helps clarifying on barter. At this stage, just stick to the principles which are there in the institute. Take the fair value of the asset given up as a first preference for each of these three standards, and then the fair value of the assets received. Okay, thank you very much. I hope you've liked this video. Please do like, share, subscribe, and do get in touch with me in case you have any problems. Thank you.